NASCAR, we have new developments in the deadly shooting of Laquan McDonald, the teen shot 16 times by a Chicago police officer. CNN has obtained newly released police reports from the incident. They contain officers' accounts of the shooting that happened in 2014, and they are dramatically different than what the dash cam video shows. We want to remind our viewers the video and images of McDonald's shooting are graphic, but it is important to see how they compare to the police reports. To go through these differences, I'm joined now by CNN's Rosa Flores. So, Rosa, what are the discrepancies?
Well, Fred, the headline here is that not only does Jason Van Dyke's account of what happened not match what the video shows, but the accounts of other officers on the scene don't match, and even the sergeant who reviewed the video, his account, doesn't match what we see on that video. Now, here is a summary that is included in that report that gives us a preview of what we can see when it comes to those discrepancies. I'm going to quote here. It says, Laquan McDonald was shot and killed by Chicago police officer Jason Van Dyke while McDonald was committing an aggravated assault with a knife against Officer Van Dyke and his partner, Chicago police officer Joseph Walsh. Now, that is the overall summary. Let's dig into these details. Now, of course, like Fred mentioned, this video is graphic, so we want to warn our viewers. But as you look at this video, you can see that Laquan McDonald is walking in the middle of that street, and you see responding police officers, including Jason Van Dyke. Now, we know, because we've looked at this video second by second, 6 seconds after Jason Van Dyke arrives on scene, he starts firing his weapon. Now, let's dive into his account on these police reports. He says, quote, he was swinging, referring to McDonald, the knife in an aggressive, exaggerated manner. He goes on to say, McDonald raised the knife across his chest and over his shoulder, pointing the knife at Van Dyke and attempting to kill Van Dyke. Now, here is Van Dyke's reaction to, according to what this report says, is happening. He says, in defense of his life, Van Dyke backpedaled and fired his handgun at McDonald to stop the attack. And then McDonald fell to the ground, but continued to move and continued to grasp the knife, refusing to let go of it. Now, we know that even after Laquan McDonald was on the ground, Jason Van Dyke continued to fire his weapon. Now, here's what he says about that. It says, McDonald appeared to be attempting to get up, all while continuing to point the knife at Van Dyke. Now, that is the police officer, Jason Van Dyke. Now, like I mentioned earlier, one of the things that really stands out here is that not only does Jason Van Dyke's account not match that video, here is what one of the police officers on scene also says. The officer says repeatedly, and I'm quoting here, McDonald dropped the knife. Now, of course, we don't have audio in this tape, but here's what he says next, and here's the crux of everything. McDonald ignored the verbal direction and instead raised his right arm towards Officer Van Dyke as if to attack Van Dyke. Then the sergeant, who reviews the video and looks at the accounts, what we just went over, also mentioned in the report that the accounts of the witnesses were consistent with the video, which, of course, now we know as we're looking at this, it doesn't match. Now, Fred, I want to leave you with one last thing that stood out to me as I'm going through these reports, and this is this alert, because Jason Van Dyke makes a note in his account of what happened as to why he fired. Now, he refers to an alert from back in 2012 that says that there is a knife revolver, a knife that's out there, according to records, that can also be a revolver and be shot like a weapon.
All right, Rosa Flores, keep us posted on that. We're going to talk more about this with our legal guys. Rosa, thank you. Joining me right now, Avery Freedman, a civil rights attorney and law professor. Richard Herman, a New York criminal defense attorney and law professor. Richard, the superintendent has already been let go, but where do you see this investigation going? I mean, is this a matter of there's no way Chicago police can investigate itself or even that jurisdiction investigate itself, but it needs to go, in your view, straight to the Justice Department?
A couple of graphic points, Fred. First of all, the feds have been there for 6 months. That's number one. Number two, the video, it took 1 year to release this video and get an indictment on a case that could have been indicted within 30 days. That's because the mayor had a tough primary runoff during that year and an election during that year. The firing of the police chief was absurd. The mayor has to go. The buck stops with him. If you think he paid $5 million in a quick settlement and didn't see this video, oh my God, I got a bridge to sell you here. These police officers and this account, this version coming by the shooter, Van Dyke, will ensure a jury convicts him. The more this insanity comes into play here, Fred, a jury is going to look at him, hear his explanation, look at this video, and convict him. They need to plea bargain this case immediately. He's going to get convicted by a jury.